In this video, we're going to take a look at IntelliJ IDEA's built-in terminal. This does perform the same function as the operating system's terminal or command feature, but using the terminal inside IntelliJ IDEA has a number of benefits. In this example, we have a simple Spring Boot application that needs a running MongoDB database. We can open the terminal window with Option and F12 or Alt and F12. The terminal supports all the same commands that the operating system supports. I'm running on a Mac, so I can use my usual Mac or Linux commands here. I want to start my MongoDB database instance with a specific path for storing the data. So I'll use mongod --dbpath with the location of the current path. Now MongoDB is running in this terminal session, and I can go back to writing the application code in the editor. By using the built-in terminal, we don't have to switch between applications, and we can easily have all aspects of our development right in front of us in the same window. This session is busy running MongoDB, and I'm happy with that. So let's open a new terminal tab with Command and T, or Control Shift and T on Windows and Linux, to run some other commands. Let's run the MongoDB shell, so we can interact with the server that's running, and check everything is okay for our application. Running commands in different tabs is helpful, but sometimes two different processes are closely related and we want to see them together. For this, we can split our terminal window so that we can run two in the same window. Let's open up the MongoDB shell in this split window so we can see if the commands we run have any impact on the running server. We can run any type of command from the terminal window. For example, although IntelliJ IDEA has full integration with Gradle, sometimes we might want to check a build tool like Gradle or Maven runs correctly from the command line. We might sometimes do this with different Java versions or different arguments to those we're using in the application. Given that we might be using a number of terminal sessions with a number of different processes or parameters, it's useful to rename the tabs to something helpful. That way, we can easily reopen the one we're interested in. We can move between the different tabs with Command, Shift, and Square Bracket on macOS, or Alt and Left and Right Arrow on Windows. We can switch between the splits with Alt and Tab, or Control and Tab on Windows. We can close splits or tabs with the usual Close Tab shortcut, which is Command W on macOS, or Control and F4 on Windows. Often, our terminal sessions will be at different paths or have different settings. There's a really nice feature of the terminal window in IntelliJ IDEA. If we close the project and then reopen it, we'll not only see our named terminal tabs are still there, but their settings are retained as well. Running command line processes from inside IntelliJ IDEA is useful for keeping us in the same context while we're developing. And it's also helpful for sharing things between different parts of our application. For example, if we're running the Java REPL JShell in an IntelliJ IDEA terminal window, it's easy to copy code from the editor and paste it into JShell. This is not specific to running JShell in the terminal. It's easy to copy and paste code from anywhere in IntelliJ IDEA into the terminal window. The integration provided by the IDE also extends to being able to open a location from inside the project window in the terminal window. So we can have a terminal window in the correct location immediately without having to navigate via the command line. Again, I'm going to use Command and W to close this tab. And I'm going to close the project window by pressing Command and 1 twice. We can always navigate back to the editor from anywhere by pressing Escape. And we can go back to the terminal window using Alt and F12 again. The IntelliJ IDEA terminal offers even more integration to make our jobs as developers easier. For this example, I'm going to run a Maven target that fails. The terminal window makes URLs clickable, so we can open a link like this one in the browser simply by clicking on it. File names in the terminal can also link back to the file in the project. In a stack trace like this, we can click on the file name and IntelliJ IDEA will open this file and put the caret on the line that caused the problem. This takes some of the pain out of debugging problems. You may notice that some commands in a terminal window are highlighted. This is a new feature in IntelliJ IDEA 2020.2. It shows that this command could be run in the IDE. We don't need to use the command line. If it's highlighted in yellow and we press Enter, the command will be run in the terminal window just as we'd expect. We can see this Maven clean command runs successfully, but with some warnings. Let's type the command again, but this time let's use Command and Enter on macOS or Control and Enter on Windows and Linux. IntelliJ IDEA will run the command using the Maven build features in IntelliJ IDEA. We can still see the command line output like before, but we also see the IDE's version, which more clearly shows that there are some warnings that might need to be addressed. IntelliJ IDEA will detect a number of different commands that could be run in the IDE instead of from the command line. This git command executes normally if we press Enter, but if we press Command and Enter, it opens the git log window in IntelliJ IDEA. This is a really good way to discover features in the IDE that are an alternative approach to using the command line. If we decide we're not going to need these suggestions, we can turn off Run Commands Using the IDE from the terminal window settings. The commands will no longer be highlighted. But if we do think this might be helpful, we can keep it turned on. We always have the option of running it either in the terminal or in the IDE. IntelliJ IDEA's terminal window is a powerful and helpful tool for developers. It keeps our attention in the same tools, so reduces context switching. It makes it easy for us to share things between the code and the command line. It's integrated, so we can easily move from the project code to the terminal and back again. And it also can show us alternative ways of doing the same thing, using the IDE's version of the command line tool. Thanks for watching.